Welcome to the basement, y'all. I'm Hannibal. These are still my thoughts, just my thoughts. Not a prescription, not a directive, just my thoughts. So you can take them or not. As a matter of fact, I don't even want you to take them. I just want you to think about it. Start a conversation. Let's talk about real stuff. You know, we talk about so much frivolousness. That's my new word for garbage, BS. Ness. Yes, ness. My word. Wonderful thing happened to me this morning. Usually when I drop my daughters off to school, so my days, alarm clock or not, start at like 5 o'clock, 4:53, 5:12, somewhere in there. My body wakes me up. My alarm said to go off at 5:30, but doesn't happen. I don't get there. So I'm up, got to do the breakfast and the drop off for the girls, and boom, keep it moving. So try to be productive, or try to keep some type of routine. And as I've said, my workout routine has been off, and I'm really just getting back to it, dealing with these. I'm not even gonna call them injuries anymore, because we're beyond that. I'm just gonna call them things that I've had to deal with. So when I drop my daughters off, actually in between dropping them off, because there's a little bit of a gap, I actually hit the park and do some cardio and some HIIT. So this morning, I'm at the park, getting it in. Just, I tend to put my headphones in, my cap pulled down, and I'm in workout mode. And that's just how I do when I'm in workout mode. Done that for, probably about 35 years now, something like that. Anyway, working out, and I hear this voice. It's saying, good morning, mister. And I zone out, or should I say I zone in. Not that I'm ignoring, but I just tend to zone in to my zone. And I realize that, because I was one of maybe, I don't know, two or three people at the park at that time, that this voice was talking to me. And so I look over my shoulder, and it's a little boy walking with his mom, or a lady. I'm gonna say it was his mom that time of morning. So, and he's just waving and saying, good morning, mister. And I have to tell you, that was my pick-me-up for the day. That was the thing that kind of, aside from seeing my daughters this morning and kissing them on the forehead and wishing them off, that was the next best thing that happened this morning. Because it made me remember, you see, sometimes we have to be reminded. It made me remember that there is default, there is natural good in people. And we just have to see that. We have to find that amongst all of the otherness that goes on. Because people are quick to remind you of why you don't mess with them no more. People remind us. Just like they say, when somebody shows you who they are, believe them. Someone tells you who they are, take them at their word. When they show you, believe them. Words don't necessarily mean much, but give it some credence. But this little boy showed me who he was as a being. Just as cheerful and true as he could be. And again, as kids, we aren't born with this, with what's the word I'm looking for? We aren't born with racism. We aren't born with looking down our nose at people. This little boy would have said hi to me, and just as well as he probably would have a homeless guy or some other guy or lady at the park. But that, to me, this morning, that was, it stuck in my head. It said, sometimes we have to be reminded. We have to be reminded of the good, and we have to be reminded of the bad. And as I said, they're going to remind you. The question is, are you taking note? See, sometimes when you run into or you deal with or you reach out to people who you don't deal with for certain reasons, and they remind you, just say, thank you for reminding me. Now, they're probably going to be thinking something else. I don't know, whatever it is they brought to you or came at you with, when you say that, they're probably going to be thinking something else. But you know what you meant, and they know subconsciously, but they'll get it. Sometimes you just say, thank you for reminding me, and you keep it moving. And sometimes you say, thank you for reminding me, and you barriers, that's the word I was looking for. They aren't born with the barriers. You're reminded and you get rid of some of those barriers. Understand, everybody doesn't think like you, but that doesn't mean that you shut the world out. Also understand that even though you may see the negative in a lot of people, there is still good in those people. There is still good in millions of people. You know, the analogy of it is this. People that perfect lies because they learn how to take truth and mix it in to the whole of that lie. And so, even in darkness, there's light. So if I can mix that up and confuse you, then of course, I was successful. So I say that to say, again, people aren't all bad. Nobody's perfect. I know I'm not. But allow yourself to be reminded, because it can be so refreshing. Even if it is a reminder of the negative, it still can be refreshing, because if you find yourself going a little, let's say, going into something that you, situation, job, people, place, and you're walking down that street, let's say you're going back to a neighborhood that you got no business being in, and as you're walking down the street going to your destination, you start seeing things in the neighborhood that are like, yeah, I remember. Those are your reminders. That's your checkpoint to change direction. So again, sometimes we just have to allow ourselves to be reminded. I'm open. What you got? I've been reminded today. and I'm thankful for it. I'm sure you have been too. Were you paying attention? Thoughts from the Basement, bonus edition. Peace out, y'all.